Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to be teaching you fraction operations. Now, before I get started, if you like my videos, please consider subscribing to my channel and turn on post notifications so you never miss out on a video. Let's get into it. So, fraction operations. And I highly recommend that you watch my other two fraction videos, Introduction to Fractions and Equivalent and Simplifying Fractions, as you will need that information in this video. Let's move on. So, before I talk about adding in our four operations, fractions are considered a number, right? They're part of a number. So, you can do operations with them. You can add, subtract, multiply, divide, and even do order of operations, and etc. But in this video, I'm going to talk about the four basic operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, and I'll teach you how to solve them. So, let's get on to it. So, adding fractions. When adding fractions, you need to make sure that the denominator is the same. If they are the same, then you can add them. If they aren't the same, then you need to change them. So this is where you need to watch the equivalent fractions video. Because we know that fractions can change, can represent the same parts, but have a different denominator, okay? So let's start off with first part. So you need to make sure they're the same. And if they are the same, then you can add them. So let's talk about 2/5 plus 2/5, okay? So if the denominator is the same, we don't add them, okay? We keep them the same, and that's what we always do. So we keep the denominator as the numerator. So we add 2 plus 2 is 4, and then we keep the denominator of 5. So 2/5 plus 2/5 is considered 4/5. Now you might be asking, why are we keeping the denominator? Well, if I drew a rectangle, best thing to do. 1, 2, 3. Okay, and cut it into 5 parts. I first shade in 1 part, 2 parts. Okay, this is the 2/5 over here. Now, if I shade in another 2 parts, okay, from this one, I get 1, 2. So as you can see, since they're the same parts, we just add them. So then we get 4/5, okay? So let's move on to subtracting fractions. And yeah, if you any time in the video you have a question, please post that in the comment section alongside the video time. That way I can help you, okay? So yeah, let's explain about what if they're not the same. So we know that a fraction like 1/5 or 2/5, we can change. Like the fraction 1/2, okay? If we multiply the numerator and denominator by 2, we can get 2/4, okay? So how is this going to help us? Let's say we have a fraction 1/2 plus 1/4, okay? We have 4ths over here and halves over here. And since the denominator is not the same, we need to change them. And we know we can change fractions because it will just be a different fraction, but it will represent the same parts. So, if I want to convert, I need to find the lowest common multiple. Or the lowest common multiple is a multiple that is the shortest, because then you're going to have to simplify fractions. So, and that is like a shortcut. So, we know that 2 and 4 have something in common. 2 times 2 is 4. So, I can change this, and I can keep this the same. And yes, if they have nothing in common, you can multiply them. Let's say this was a 3, okay? You can do 2 times 3, and then get 6. But 2 and 4 have something in common, 4. So I'm going to do that. So I'm going to change 1/2 to 2/4, and which we already did up here, times 2, times 2. We always multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number. So we know 2/4 is that, and then plus 1/4. Okay? So we add the numerator, keep the denominator. Okay? 3/4. Okay? Let's move on to subtracting fractions. Just like adding fractions, you need to have the same denominator, okay? So let's start off with a simple version. So let's say I have 5/7. Wait, no, not 5/7. Let me erase that. Let's say I have 3/5 minus 1/5. Just like before, we subtract the numerators but keep the denominators. So 2/5. And to show that, we can visualize using a rectangle. So I'm going to draw draw a rectangle and cut it into 5 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Then we first shaded the first fractions, 3/5. 1, 2, 3. And we take out 1/5. So I'm going to use a different color and I'm going to X off this one. So we have 2/5 or 2 out of the 5 parts that are shaded. Okay? Let's move on to the harder part of subtracting. So, like I said before, we can change the fraction into something equivalent. And like we did with addition, we can do that with subtraction. So let's say we have 1/2 minus 1/3. Now, like I said, 2 and 3, if they don't have anything in common, multiply them. And that will find us the LCM. And I always suggest finding the LCM, because that will help you when you're done solving the equation, and then you don't have to simplify. So 1/2 minus 1/3, they have nothing in common because the denominator 2 and 3 have no common multiple. Like, they have nothing in common with 2 and 4. But I know that 2 times 3 is 6, right? And 6 is a multiple of 2 and a multiple of 3. So that must be the lowest common multiple. So I'm going to convert both of them to 6. So 1/2 to 6. So I multiply by 3. And multiply by 3 because anything you multiply by the numerator has to be multiplied by the denominator, same way backwards. So 3/6 we can. Okay? Sorry, it's okay. And 1/3 to 6 is times 2 times 2. So 2/6. So we know that 3/6 minus 2/6 equals 1/6. Okay, because we always keep the keep the denominators, subtract numerators. So now we're gonna move on to multiplying and dividing, and I highly suggest that you don't get them mixed up, because multiplying and dividing have a different way of doing. And just like I said, adding and subtracting are the same because they're inverse operations. So multiplying and dividing are inverse operations, therefore they will be similar too. So multiplying fractions are really easy. All you need to do is multiply the numerator and the denominators. So any fraction you could think of, 3/7, okay, times 5/8. You don't even need anything common. You don't need a numerator common or a denominator common, nothing. Okay? So all we gotta do is multiply. So I get 15/56. Now remember how I said simplifying fractions, right? You have to do that at the end. Well, like I said, with addition and subtraction, if you find the LCM, it's like a shortcut. And multiplying fractions and dividing fractions, there's another shortcut. So over here, we can't do the shortcut. But let's say if I were to have a different fraction. Like, let's say I were to have 5/7. And, 5/7 times 14/20, okay? So 5 and 20 have something in common, right? 20 is the 4th multiple of 5, right? So, and 5 is the 1st multiple of 5. So we cross this out and make it 1. And over here, we cross it out and make that, four, sorry. Okay? Then, you do that, so we can do that with 7 and 14 again. I can make that 1, and I can make that 2. Okay? And I get 2/4, right? 2/4. Which then again can be simplified to 1/2. You have to do something. If I were to multiply them, I would get 80. So I would get, 5 times 14 is 50 plus 20 is 70 over 7 times 20 is 140, which is 1 half. And yeah, the 1 halves are really easy to simplify, but it's always better to have a way like this where you can simplify the fractions, okay? So let's move on. Dividing fractions. Dividing fractions is like multiplying fractions. But first, you need to find the reciprocal of the second fraction. Now, what is the reciprocal? Well, it's like the opposite of the fraction. And so you can find that by flipping the numerator and denominator. Then you multiply. So I'll explain what that means. So we have 1/3, okay? And we want to divide it into 1/4. Okay? So what you technically do is you take the second fraction, which in this case is your 1/4, and you flip it. So instead of 4 being the denominator, it's the numerator. And 1 becomes the denominator. So technically the equation becomes 1/3, instead of dividing, multiply, times 4 over 1. And like I said, 1 and 1 cancel each other, so it's really just 4/3. And to simplify that, you make it a mixed number of 1/1/3. Because we know if the numerator is ever bigger than the denominator, it's improper fraction. And we want it's highly recommended for students to change it to a mixed number. Now I have some practice problems for you. Okay? So my first practice problem is 1/3 plus 3/6. My second problem is 1/3. Wait, no, not 1/3 again. Five eighths times 8/9. Okay? And my third one is 3/4 divided by 7/8. Okay? So you can pause the video to solve them. I'll give you 5 seconds in the video, but you can always pause. Okay, now I'm going to go over the answers. So the first one is addition, right? So I know I need to find a common denominator. So what's really a problem is that many students get addition and subtraction confused with multiplication and division, okay? So first we're going to do addition. So these are not, 3 and 6 are not the same, right? So we need to combine them to something that is the same. I know that 3 and 6 have something in common, 6. So I can convert 1/3 to 6. And I know that 1/3 to 3 to 6 is times 2. So I do 1/3 times 2 over 2 is the same as, sorry, not 2 over 2, times 2 times 2. You never want to write it like that because that's kind of wrong. Times 2 and then times 2 gets me 2/6. And 2/6 plus 3/6 equals 5/6. Okay? Next one is multiplication. I know that 8 and 8 are the same number, so I just cancel that out to 1 and 1. So really the answer is 5/9. And yeah, if you don't understand this method, don't do it. It's always a shortcut and a challenging part, but as they say, slow and steady wins the race, okay? And then division, so I just flip it, so it's 3/4. Sorry if you can't see it, let me, 3/4 times 8 over 7. I can also do the crossing out method in this. 1, 2, and that equals 6, 7. I hope you enjoyed this video, and, click on screen for my other helpful tips. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please remember to subscribe to my channel, turn on post notifications, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.